Ben works out with the staff. All next on Live. Now, here are Kelly Ripa and Ryan Seacrest.
Can we take your coat?
Sure.
Can we? Come, stay, relax, sit down, stay. I feel like. I felt like she. You never know. I mean, maybe they're going to decide to walk out in 2 minutes. I don't
this
know.
Is what my, this is what my parents would.
County.
My husband's brother, everybody. My parents would say to you, why don't you take your coat off and stay a while? But I always say, when you turn the heat on in here, I will. Because it's cold in here.
It is Thursday, December 28th. Good to have you with us. Nice
yes.
to see you.
I do it every year.
Go on.
I do it every year. Happy birthday to my best friend growing up, Scotty Silber. It is, he's always.
Scotty Silber?
Scotty Silber is my best friend. We were best friends since birth on, and his birthday was always 3 days after Christmas, and we always used to say that he would, like, be robbed of certain gifts because it'd be like, Christmas had just happened, so he would get, like, you know, whatever was left over from
right.
they didn't give him for Christmas, he got for his birthday.
I have a best friend named Reagan Silber, and I wonder
if
they are related. Now, this Reagan Silber hails from Texas.
Oh.
So, different
no,
part.
He's from New Jersey.
But, you know, there's one Texan here. How are you? By the way, speaking of, you said that you're cold.
I'm freezing.
Okay. Now, and I know that the America and Canada, they both know that you like it warm always. You
hot.
Like to you like it hot. You like it in the bedroom, you like it hot.
I like, it oppressively
like the house hot.
Hot.
Mm-hmm. You like it hot.
I like it so hot. I like it so hot that the devil himself would be like, it's hot in here.
Because there was an article about getting your beds ready for the really cold winter that's coming and what you have to do. They say layers and blankets and get sheets with warmth built into the sheets.
Mm.
Do you have all of that? How many layers? What's the epidermis structure, epidermal structure, the layers, the mantle,
when you,
the core?
When you look at our bed.
Yeah.
When you look at our bed, it's like two different beds almost because Mark has like a light sheet on the bed.
I just picture blowing in the wind.
Yeah, he's got like a gauzy
like
sheet.
A Sade music video.
And I have like three quilts. I have a flannel. I have flannel sheets. I have my own blanket. Then I'm wearing like a onesie usually. Because
right.
I'm so cold.
So Shayna likes it. She actually likes it cold.
You know, it's weird.
It's weird. She will, like, make a chill happen so that. I said, why are you making it so, it's cold out. Why are you making it so cold? Oh, so that we can get warm when we get into the bed.
And do you sleep in the nude?
Well, you dare say it. And here's the thing. We got new sheets. And these sheets, I never slept in the nude before. And we moved to New York and we got new sheets. And she said to me, you know, these sheets are really magical. And I said, yeah, they're comfortable. She said, but like, they're really comfortable. So one night, I took off my shirt. And I was like, these sheets are very comfortable.
You okay? And Did somebody jump? Dead.
I know, my nudity will scare you. I'm used to that. It's physically harming. But now I have recently been doing that because we have these sheets and
I can't. So you're nude.
Well, I can't get the sheets are so. It's not attractive. It's not festive.
Don't worry. We'll be the judge.
No, it's not festive. But if there's a fire, I've thought about that. I actually do have. I have.
You keep your panties next to the bed.
I have. I have my Uggs and my
pants.
Pull-ups. Yeah.
Your pull-ups? Your big boy pull-ups?
My big boy pull-ups.
Do they have Buzz Lightyear on them?
I think they've got Star Wars on them. But But anyway, so I've just started just because of these sheets, and you lay in the sheet and you think, God, this does feel good.
I have never, I'm not like big on sleeping in the nude, especially in the winter, but sometimes in the summer I will go down to like my Fruit of the Loom t-shirt and my underpants.
I've got to get you these sheets though.
That's as nude as I get.
That's it.
That's like full nudity. That's like honeymoon nudity.
What have you ever been 17, 18 years on the show, right? You've been in this seat?
It feels much longer.
But it doesn't look like you've been here that long, for sure. Have you ever been late? Have you ever been late?
No.
It says about 1 in 5 workers are late a few times a week.
A few times a week.
They're late.
That's fascinating.
I think that's...
That would be amazing, though. Wouldn't it be amazing to show up here a few times? Like, imagine me just like... Right? Here I come. I'm going to act it out.
Okay, it's Tuesday.
Oh, hey.
Oh, Kelly.
Oh, Kelly.
Sorry, I'm late.
Yeah, nice to have you.
Sorry, am I late?
Yeah, sorry.
Wait, hang on.
You ever slept?
Wait, I'm sorry. Am I late? Can I miss anything?
Only the second time this week already.
Oh my gosh. I didn't know.
I think because of the business that we're in, the job that we're in, things are live. They start on the second, they end on a second. I get rash if I'm late, and I'm running late to something. You know, like I feel like if other people are waiting.
Well, there have been times where there have been like situations where I've gotten out of the car and I've run through the park to get here on time because
you were close.
There's a shut down street, they've shut down this, something's happened, a president's in town, you don't know, you never really know what's gonna happen, but sometimes when they shut it down, it's shut down, you're not moving. So I've hopped out of the car
and you've sprinted across the park.
And I've sprinted across the park just to make sure that I get here on time.
I have friends, some of my friends, I don't out them, Lawrence and Janelle, who are who are usually running a few minutes behind. So there's two things that happen. This is, with the social engagement. One, I will text them and say, are you here yet? And I'm in the car still. So here meaning, so they think I'm there already.
Right.
So they feel the pressure to hurry up and get there. So we meet at the same time.
That's
one way to do it. And then the other thing is I give them, as a lot of people do, a different start time for things so that they get there. You cheat them, right,
well,
exactly.
Well, I had an ex-boyfriend before Mark that was chronically late. Chronically. I mean,
this is not Silver, is it?
No. No, he's my best friend.
Okay.
He wasn't my boyfriend.
All right.
So chronically late. And so it got to the point where when we were no longer together, I just assumed that people were chronically 2 hours late for everything. So Mark and I decide to go on a date, and he says, I'll pick you up at 7. And so to me, that means 9:20. So bing, bong, bing, the door. Who could that be? I'm in a robe and a towel on my head. Now, in going back in time, Mark likes to tell the story that I tried to seduce him on our first date, which is totally not what happened at all. I just had a towel on my head because my hair was wet, no makeup on, and a bathrobe. But according to Mark, that was my modus operandi. I was there to seduce him with my hot towel look in my hideous bathrobe.
In your terry cloth.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, you're so early. He goes, it's 7 o'clock. You said 7 o'clock. And he really is, like, with military precision, he is on time, which I've learned is how most people operate. But so...
Well, what's interesting about your husband being militant with time is that I know that. Yeah. And so when we make plans with you guys, we get there 25 minutes before the reservation just to make him crazy because he's got everything else.
When we walked into the restaurant and you were there, that made him so anxious. He was
fantastic.
Riddled with anxiety. And he's like, and you wanted to go back and get a coat. And I was like...
Listen, I look at the guy. It's true.
We are 3 minutes early.
He has got me beat in every category, but he will not be there before I am. I'll tell you that. We back it up hours That's before right. the reservation That's right. these days.
Hey, on today's show, Oprah Winfrey is here.
Also, Archie from Riverdale. Hey, J Apa is here.
Favorite. This is what I love saying. We're gonna see what happened when Ryan worked out and slash bonded with the staff.
Yeah,
I like it. One workout is all it took.
What is that? And it was.
Together.
Yeah. Once you
so
perspire with this.
So one workout is all it took. It took me like 5 years to bond.
No, just get the body temperature up and everybody's friends. A performance by Dua Lipa coming too.
Yeah.
And it's time for. Morning Wake Up Travel Trivia. Here we go. We're in awe. We're in awe. That was great. Thank you. That is Jordan
that was so good.
Stefanski from Old Bridge, New Jersey. Jordan.
This is awesome.
You're awesome. You're awesome. That was fun.
It was.
Thank you for being here. Okay, we're going to call Anthony from Port Orange, Florida right now to see if Anthony is available to win a trip. A beautiful trip.
It sounds nice, Port Orange, doesn't it? Where do you live? Port Orange, Florida.
Any port.
There's a song in my head.
What is it?
I don't know.
Are there voices or just a song?
Just a song.
Because I have voices. That's four.
Come on,
Anthony. Oh, Anthony. He's out enjoying Port Orange. All right. Don't worry, we have a plan.
Yeah,
don't worry. We're gonna call Gina from Alexandria, Virginia. Fairfax, Alexandria.
That got a reaction.
Yeah.
I'm beginning to wonder. This audience likes Virginia. All right, Virginia, Virginia, Virginia.
These are big fans of the show that have written in. Yeah, people are on holiday schedules, Gelman.
Who were we calling?
We're calling Gina from Alexandria, Virginia.
Gina, or is it pronounced Gina?
I don't know. We'll never know.
You don't know.
Well, you don't, do you?
You don't know.
You just don't know.
Right, some people pronounce it Gina.
Today, but...
Oh, okay. Even though we're not going to play today, there's still good news.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something, Gelman. This audience could use some good news, I can tell. We're going to give a $500 appliance package from Cuisinart.
Kelly, I'll pick a number. All right, I'll pick a number. All right, take a look at numbers. Lucky number 96, I'm guessing over here. 96, right there. Congratulations. All right, Oprah, next. Be right back.
Still ahead on Live, a performance by Dua Lipa. We'll see how well Ryan bonds with his staff after a workout in the park. Archie from Riverdale, KJ Apa. And coming up next, Oprah Winfrey.
In the world, please welcome back to the show, Oprah Winfrey.
I've never done Kelly and Ryan with Ryan.
Isn't it nice?
It's nice.
Oprah, I've got to tell you that it goes without saying that when you come to the studio, something happens.
What happens?
The studio vibrates. People sleep in full hair and makeup, and I don't just mean Ryan. There is an electricity.
Well, thank you that for
is, that. It's a very positive effect on all of us.
Well, thank you. Thank you. did the exact same thing in the hotel last night. I bring my satin pillow.
Yes.
I sleep on the satin pillow. And then you're trying to, like, so you don't lay flat so your eyes aren't puffy in the morning.
Yes.
And then you wake up and you're on your face. You're like,
how did I get here?
How did I get here?
Who flips us over?
I don't know.
I don't know. Oprah, you've got to fix it. If anybody can fix that phenomenon,
it's okay. It's okay.
Okay.
I slip on my, like, I have a, but I just end up
you
sliding
slide right
down.
Off?
And you can't even, am I still there?
I would have said you were 6'1", by the way.
Oh, I said 6'1". 6'1".
You
have. Spreading positivity throughout the land.
Spreading height and positivity.
So now you had a big travel adventure, right?
Well,
you...
yes, I spent the whole year with a magazine doing what I call the year of adventure. And we ended with this wonderful trip on an Alaskan cruise with a lot of our readers for the magazine. Have you ever been to Alaska?
I've never been. Have you been?
No, but I've been to Vancouver, which I think is like probably a similar experience. We saw orcas, and I know you saw bald
yes,
eagles.
Yes, bald eagle.
And you saw, yeah. Like, you was, see wild nature.
I was looking at the eagles, and then the captain says,
wow. Two of them.
And then he says, no, you're following a pigeon.
Yeah. No, is that true?
It's true. You got to know the difference between the eagle and pigeon. There were two eagles, and then I thought the other, that was an eagle flying. It was a pigeon.
Because you get so, when you see a bald
it's
eagle
so
flying,
it's so thrilling.
It takes your breath away,
yes,
right?
Yes, and then you're like, it's an eagle.
It's an eagle,
so
yes.
What was, because it is on my list to go there, what was magical about being
well, seeing the glaciers, which are getting smaller every year, yeah. Melting, so seeing that, you know, beautiful glacier. I also this year, for Wrinkle in Time, traveled to New Zealand. It should be on your bucket list.
Uh-huh.
Put it on your bucket list.
Yes,
this photo is
extraordinary.
And look at that water behind me. It is like crystal blue. I mean, no kind of Instagram. Fixing up stuff.
You don't even need a filter.
You don't, no filter, right. Nothing. It just is like, because the water's coming off of the glaciers,
so
and it enters, and it's just like, from the minerals, it's like pure turquoise.
How long were you there?
We were there 3 weeks filming, and I think the experience of creating that film there is going to make for, you know, the wonderful experience translates
what
into
What about
the film.
Your role? Who are you playing?
Oh. Have you read the book?
I have read the book.
Okay.
But I also saw a photo of your character.
I actually didn't read the book growing up. Anybody read Wrinkle in Time?
Yeah, we read it.
Yeah, it was required reading.
It was required reading.
For us.
Oh, well, not my neighborhood. But anyway. No, did you see that photo?
But so the photograph is incredible.
Witch. I am Mrs. Witch. There are three witches. There are three Mrs. Mm. There's Mrs. What's It, Mrs. Who, and I am Mrs. Witch, which Ava DuVernay, and when you read the book, we all look like Mrs. Doubtfire in your imagination.
Right, right.
But Ava DuVernay had this idea of creating, you know, a diverse group of Mrs. And so it's Mindy Kaling and Reese Witherspoon and myself.
She's terrific.
And I wear the most fantastic wigs. That's Kim
that
Humble doing that wig.
Incredible. That's incredible. That's a photo I saw.
Wow.
Isn't that?
Mm-hmm. Now, I understand that you, for the cast and crew, you were making margaritas.
I am a stone good margarita maker.
Wow.
And I hear I might have some competition.
My husband, Mark, who I know you know very well, he makes an incredible...
Does he squeeze his own limes?
He squeezes his own limes on top once it's blended.
Oh, no,
he
no,
makes
no,
a frozen...
No, no.
Yes.
No.
It's a family recipe. It's a
okay,
family...
Okay, but
from
is he...
Mexico.
Okay.
It's from Mexico.
Okay.
Just say.
I'm for all that. I'm not going to try to beat the Mexicoans and the Mexicans at margarita. I'm actually going to concede to that.
Okay.
What are your ingredients for the fresh
ingredients
margarita?
The ingredients is just lime, pure lime, and you've got to make sure that it's fresh squeezed lime juice. And, you know, when I was in New Zealand, I was actually squeezing it myself so that nobody throws any of that mixed stuff in there.
Oh, you've got
the sugar and the sweetener and all the syrup.
You just want that and pure, the best tequila you can
find. Casa Dragones is
absolutely
the tequila. It's very clear tequila, right?
Right.
In the blue box. Yeah.
Crystal.
Yeah. You feel obligated to drink a lot because it's in such a nice box.
I have, as you know.
What's your limit, actually?
Me?
Yes.
Like,
what's your limit? What's the maximum amount of tequila shots you can handle?
Shots. She said shots.
Oh, I mean, you know, I like to think of myself as 78% tequila, so I'm pretty hollow. I can put it away.
Really?
Yeah, I can. I can. We can go drinking if you want.
I'd go drinking with you.
I mean, you let me know, and you're busier than I am.
What's your max?
I won't even say, because then people will...
It's off the charts.
I won't even say, because there's something in Santa Barbara called the Fiesta.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I actually went out with my friends to Fiesta, and I was training other people how to drink shots. I was coaching people into... Ask Jalinda Dvorsan how good of a trainer I am. Yes,
I can... You know what? I like this... I like the alcohol-infused life coach of Oprah.
Yes.
I like that.
It's a part of me you don't know. Understand. I was the victor that night. Larry Gordon said at the end of the night, he says, "What are you, a effing moose? I don't know what you are, because
no, some people can really process
it into
energy. We turn it into spirituality.
Turn it into fun and spirituality.
An awakening.
An awakening.
Mindfulness.
A tequila awakening.
We'll come back with Oprah right after this and talk about her star-studded Sunday gospel brunch.
Up that night, and he was taking notes and like writing.
I underlined in the book.
Underlining and writing.
You can.
And
I did.
Yeah.
Okay. Tell me. I'm interested in what interests you.
I love these kinds of books because we live a busy life, and simple clarity I find very useful.
Don't you like it?
And
don't you think it's a wonderful gift?
It's like all of a sudden. I talked about this yesterday on the radio.
It changed my life.
Really? Just one paragraph.
He came into makeup and hair yesterday, and he goes, "Oprah just fixed my life." And I go, Welcome to the party.
I want to know what it was.
So Devon Franklin, on the page, Devon Franklin.
Devon
Franklin. You say, the truth is you and I are in control of only two things. So we can only control two things. And this simplifies life if you break it down. How we prepare for what might happen and how we respond to what just happened.
Does happen.
Everything else is part of the grand movie.
Yes, absolutely.
Movie.
Absolutely.
That brought some clarity.
You know why I really love this? This is The Wisdom of Sundays is a compilation of all of the beautiful conversations I've had and the aha moments I had while listening to them. So it's really, I went through all those conversations, over 200 conversations.
Right.
And picked the moments that resonated with me. Because, you know, sometimes you're talking to a guest on the show.
Yeah.
And this used to happen to me all the time. And your little hairs on your arm are raised.
Well, it happens every time you walk out.
This is what you know. If that's happening to you, it's happening to lots of other people too.
Right, correct.
Who are vibing with you.
Right.
So I picked those moments that I felt were essential to opening the spirit. I talk about your own spiritual GPS, meaning all of us has that thing inside of us that knows what is right and what is wrong. And when you hear it, it resonates with you and you go, aha. So an aha moment is really something you already know that just got triggered and you remember
it. And it's in such a great format because I literally sat down and I read almost the whole thing.
Yes, but it's lots of different people and it's short.
Yes.
Because I learned that people really want snackable things. Snackable wisdom that you can digest.
Yes.
So not long, drawn out stuff, but just you can get it just
the
like
wisdom
that.
Is right here. We'll be right back with Oprah.
Wisdom
Stay with us.
Sunday.
Tomorrow on Live, Jimmy.
Just want you to know that during the commercial break, Oprah inspires us. Okay? There, I said. Now, we're talking about what makes you happy in your life because you bring so much joy to all of our lives.
Simple things bring me such delight.
But you know? I love your Instagram page. I'm always like, why does my Instagram page not look like this? You posted
because I have a lot of vegetables.
Your vegetables are amazing.
I am posting vegetables. Yeah, that was picked. I usually do the picking on Thursdays, and I do some of the picking, but obviously I have help.
But I mean,
especially when it comes to arranging it in the basket.
Did Martha Stewart come over and arrange that?
I posted that, so I'm down there with everybody picking because I love to get my hands in dirt and stuff. And the guy and somebody when I posted it, that picture, somebody's like, "Oprah, this is too clean." Well, we wash it before we bring it up. Of course, you're going to rinse it off before you bring it up to the house.
This love and passion has inspired your new food line.
Yes. Right? So I was posting, and then I got a call from Kraft Heinz asking would I be interested in doing a food line. And I said yes, only because I love this idea of bringing nutritious food to communities that otherwise might not be able to have it. And also using this idea of making a twist, mm-hmm. you know, so I was sitting at home one night, honest to God, true story, and I, you know, was counting my points, and cauliflower is no point.
Right.
So I was whipping that cauliflower, you know, because they say if you whip it, it tastes like mashed potatoes.
True.
It actually tastes like whipped cauliflower.
I like it.
So, that is the truth. You can pretend all damn day long, and it's still just, you can say, boy, I'm pretending it's a mashed potatoes. But I was just sitting there thinking,
it's the same color.
It's the same. How can I make this actually feel like potatoes? Oh, what if I put some potatoes in there? So I got up, went to the kitchen, boiled a potato.
Oh my gosh.
Yes. With some potato and cauliflower.
With some potato and cauliflower.
So
and then
that.
The next time I made it, I worked with Kraft Heinz, literally. I was up in the kitchens in Chicago, finding out what's the right mixture of cauliflower. You want to be able to taste a little bit of the cauliflower, but you don't want the cauliflower overwhelming you. You want more potato than cauliflower. So that was just the idea.
So it's like a nutritious take on easy packaged foods.
That's right. And I love soups, and I've loved soups since I was a kid, since watching Lassie.
And can I just say one more thing?
Campbell's used to sponsor Lassie.
Wait,
mm-hmm, good.
Can I say one more thing?
Yeah.
When you came out and said, I love bread, you made bread safe again. And
well, I love bread, and I eat bread, but when I said that, it means you don't go eat a loaf.
No, we know.
Yes,
no.
Portion control.
It's portion control.
Portion
I do love
control.
It. But if you just tell yourself you're never going to eat it, that's all I think about. If I say I'm never going to eat it again, so I don't do that. I don't do the nevers.
Good.
Yeah. So
and one more thing. Congratulations on 60 Minutes. You're doing great work.
Thank you. I have another story this week.
I can't wait.
Thank
really
you.
Really can't wait.
I love the process. Too.
Yeah.
Oprah Winfrey, Oh That's Good, Oprah's new food line. Information is on our website in the book, The Wisdom of Sundays. Okay, so he has stolen the hearts of millions as Riverdale's resident redhead. I practiced. Please welcome actor KJ Apa.
Did you see Jimmy Fallon backstage?
I did. He came past. I said hi.
Yeah. Oh,
he's
good.
A legend.
He loves you.
I know. We were just here last week, and we were just.
Oh, you did his show. That's right. Yeah. That's right. I forgot.
It's so bizarre to hear your voice.
I know.
Because a lot of people trip out.
In Riverdale, you have the perfect accent, which is ours.
Mm.
But now, where are you from?
New Zealand. Yeah.
Are you surprised by that, or do people know now? Some people are surprised.
A lot of people think Australia first off, but
it's close.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
no.
What does KJ stand for? Because I've never asked you that, and I...
Stands for Kennedy James, so it's someone. I'm named after my father.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Mark, my husband said that he met your father, and he just fell in love with him.
Yeah,
just like you.
Yeah, my parents came down for a bit to Vancouver. We shoot in Vancouver, so they came down.
Yeah. And your dad's a chief?
He is. He's a chief in Samoa of our village back home.
Wow.
Yeah.
So does that require,
what's the role of the chief?
It's just like certain kind of responsibilities and stuff. He lives in New Zealand. Pretty much all my family lives in New Zealand, but he can still kind of do it from over there. So, it's interesting.
Everyone here, I can read their minds, are wondering, is that your natural color hair?
No.
Right?
It's not. Thankfully for me. I don't really like, I was really nervous before we dyed it for the show. Because I knew if I was going to get the part, I'd have to dye my hair orange, which was going to be a massive...
So that's you.
Oh, there you are with your natural hair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. As soon as we finish, I'm going straight back.
You do. You don't like the process of dyeing your hair?
I don't know how girls do it.
It's
sitting there.
It's hell.
I'm
it's
in there every
hell.
Every 2 weeks, and it's just gnarly, but... Yeah.
So, just for a minute, I know her husband is there on the set as you're doing your scenes, but her husband he's 0% body fat and well-built.
Mm-hmm.
You too, I've seen the show, you're also well-built. Do you guys just work out between every take?
Mark works out a lot, eh?
He does.
I always see him at the gym.
Yeah, he sees you at the, there you, look, we have a picture of all
look
of you at the gym.
Oh, yeah.
But he's a much older man. You're not going to hurt him, are you, KJ?
Yeah, no.
He's at least your father's age. Yeah.
No, he goes hard. He goes really hard in the gym. I see him training. But, yeah, we do spend a lot of time in that gym. It's a really nice gym as well in Vancouver.
Yeah.
All right, when we come back, we're going to check out KJ's, apparently, his six-pack. That's what they tell me.
Tomorrow on Live, Jessica Alba.
You know, I have to tell you, I mean, we are objectifying you and talking about your abs and all of that, but you're such a good actor. You're really terrific on the show.
Thanks.
You really, really are.
Thank you.
Besides the emotion of sad, as Dana pointed out earlier, you also portray the emotion of shirtless. So, yeah. Are you willing to show us your abs?
Oh, maybe not. Maybe not today.
Not today. Okay, that's okay.
I think we have photographs.
That's okay. We have a collection. Dana. Dana.
Yeah.
That's it. That's a signature of your producer right there. Dana Dodge produces men, and she makes sure she shows as many topless photos as possible.
You should have heard how many phone calls we got last night. Do you understand the notes? Do you know what the talking points are?
I was just thinking about, I was telling Dana before Mavis just ripped my shirt off on stage.
Yeah,
before you guys even get to.
Happening this season? What is, or should we have Jimmy Fallon come back and tell us?
Yeah, I'm sure Jimmy knows everything. Yeah. No, this season's a lot, it's a lot darker. We have a bigger order this season, so we're doing 22 episodes. Mm. So the fans are gonna be loving that. But yeah, there's so much more that we're doing. Like obviously Mark is on the show now, which is awesome. We got some cool stuff as well between Archie and Hiram,
the
too.
The two of you have scenes together.
Yeah, because Archie goes out with Hiram's daughter, Veronica, so there's obviously some stuff that's going
to
be going on.
The plot thickens.
Yeah.
Great to see you, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
If you think Live with Kelly and Ryan is fun to watch at home, come be part of our studio audience. You can see your favorite stars, win a prize, or even become part of the show. Don't miss out. Just visit our website and get your tickets now.
Kelly was saying to me over weeks of time, you know, you have not gotten to know this staff and bonded with this staff until you really bond with the staff. So I said to the staff, I want to bond with you guys, staff. So I joined them as they were sneaking out of the office to do their workouts.
Oh, so, they do, and they're sneaking.
And then
too.
Right behind, under our noses, behind our backs, they sneak out, and they hope Gelman doesn't notice.
Well, he's in his own exercise class, so there's that.
Legs over the head, but this is what we did in the park. Take a look.
So the day I was sitting on the bench on the phone, and I saw everyone walking back, that was from this class?
That was from this class.
I was supposed to see. Because it was
on the down low.
And does Gelman know that everyone sneaks out on the time? Sorry. Do you want me to carry the bag?
Yeah, new guy. Carry the bag.
Yeah, thanks. I did this for Larry King when I met Larry King. Carry my bags, yeah. Thanks. Thanks, sir. Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
I'm Ryan.
Hi, Ryan. I'm Jen.
Jen.
Nice to meet you.
I know you are.
Stop me if you.
In 1 hour?
Yeah, we're gonna.
It's quick. It's really quick. Everything's 1 minute. Some superhero, some fairy tale bliss. Just something I can turn to. Somebody I can kiss. I want something. Everybody breathe. You guys feeling good today?
Feeling great.
Yeah. Ryan, do you have any injuries that I should know about?
I have several. Did you not get the facts I sent you?
I did not.
Yeah, they're from head to toe, my injuries.
Okay. Go. Good. Keep those abs nice and tight, flat back. You want to make that harder, you can bring your feet in a little bit more.
Yeah, just what I want. I want to make it hard. You can read my mind, Jen. Keep it down over there, John. Like, I feel like I'm too close to that rope.
Right behind you. So right up to shoulder height. Don't go past shoulder height.
Okay.
Cool. Make sure you keep your knees bent. Protect your lower back.
Got it.
All right.
Yo, yo, yo. They're too fast for me. Standing by to engage.
You're ready to go. Okay. 1 minute on the clock. Go. There you go. Good.
Get some air.
That's it.
Get some air, Shelly.
Breathing.
Yeah. Yeah, go!
Nice! There, come on, come on!
Good job, good job.
Nice.
All right.
What you mean? Oh.
Oh my God, are you making her carry you over here? Oh. Good, Lori, bring your feet out a little bit more. That's it. Are you guys
are they stuck?
Hold on.
How would you evaluate our progress so far, Jen? Pretty good.
You guys are really doing awesome.
We are doing awesome.
Yeah, you are. I mean, these guys always do awesome. For you to just come in.
I mean, how does he do it?
How do you do it?
I know it's. I'm an athlete, Jen. What are you going to do? I'm an athlete.
I'm impressed, I will say. Good. You want to exhale as you come up.
You can play tennis with that grunt.
That's right. Just grunt loudly. Here's some broken glass. Here's some gum and a balloon. Perfect.
Are you ready? Make sure those knees don't touch the ground. Nice. Go, Jim. Go, Jim. Awesome. Right here.
Oh, there's nothing comfortable about that.
That was close. Do you want to do a tiebreaker, just the two of you?
No, we like a tie. A tie settles the score perfectly. Now we all go back to work, stinky and sweaty.
One, two, three.
Go live!
All right.
To the staff?
After you spend time and you sweat with this team,
you
sweat together.
Yeah. That's right.
Right?
I mean, they're all right. They're okay. I mean, we're used to each other now. That was fun, though. It looked like fun.
It was fun. Yeah. It was fun. I feel...
She has got a name you won't forget and a sound you'll want to remember. Here is Dua Lipa with her big hit, Be The One.
Tomorrow on Live, Jimmy Fallon, Michael Weatherly, and Jessica Alba.